two popular gardening boosters, Cocopeat and Peat Moss, look similar, hold water well, and promise healthier plants. But one is eco-friendly, while the other is harming the planet. Which one should you choose? Let's find out. Hello, and welcome back to Discover Agriculture, your go-to channel for gardening tips, farming green sites, and sustainable living. Today, we are comparing Cocopeat versus Peat Moss. Their benefits, uses, and environmental impact, so you can make the best choice for your garden. Cocopeat, a lightweight, fibrous byproduct from the coconut husks, loved for water retention, aeration, and eco-friendliness. Peat Moss, decomposed sphagnum moss formed over thousands of years in wetlands, known for moisture retention and naturally acidic pH. Cocopeat holds up to 8 times its weight in water, keeps roots hydrated, and allows great airflow. Peat Moss also holds water well but compacts over time, risking poor aeration and root rot. Cocopeat, neutral to slightly acidic, contains potassium and micronutrients. Peat Moss, more acidic, perfect for acid-loving plants like blueberries but low in nutrients. Reusable, made from repurposed coconut waste, sustainable choice. Peat Moss, non-renewable, harvesting damages peat box and reduces biodiversity. Cocopeat, affordable, reusable, and widely available. Peat Moss, often pricier and breaks down faster. If you want a sustainable, versatile, and budget-friendly option, Cocopeat wins. For acid-loving plants, Peat Moss works, but its environmental cost is high. Which one do you choose in your garden? Share your experience in the comments. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell for more gardening tips from Discover Agriculture.